here today to tell all citizens of Dutchess County, Ulster County, what's been going on at the Civic Center, which I know of because for 22 years I figure skated there, usually once or twice a week year-round. So sadly, as our president would say, very sad, the situation is very sad. And I'd like to read you what a letter that was not answered, that was delivered on June 30th to Daniel Anderson, who I was told is the manager of the Civic Center. Lori May left, a wonderful person who ran a tight ship there, and I had been hearing many complaints from parents and people I skated with. So I wrote a letter requesting information for the 10th edition of my guidebook to the Hudson Valley being published in May. And the letter was hand-delivered to Daniel Anderson on June 30th. And after 6 months of following up, getting no acknowledgement or answer, I decided I had no alternative but to put in my guidebook the following statement. After skating for 22 years at the Poughkeepsie Civic Center's McCann Ice Arena, I am heartbroken to report this news. This sports facility is woefully mismanaged. I prefer not to catalog any of the ill-advised decisions that have been made here in 2017, and the complete non-responsiveness by management since the former manager resigned in early 2017. This is a tragic loss for both the city of Poughkeepsie and Dutchess County. In addition to the mismanagement of the ice rink, the Civic Center concert venue has deteriorated. All of us who have skated here for decades and supported this facility are hoping the Dutchess County business community and citizens of the county will rescue what used to be a fantastic county resource. I have to tell you, after receiving my letter, only one person besides Joel Tyner in the legislature responded, a Miss Ampro, A-M-P-R-O, and Joel Tyner. Everyone else in this county seems to feel it's okay to have someone earning $125,000 a year as manager who is mismanaging the place, but because she's married to Butch Anderson, your sheriff, she seems to be immune from criticism. Thank you.
What do you guys want to go next? I'll go last.
Sure. My name's Greg Ninos. I'm an alternate captain for Black Rhinos Hockey Club. Our hockey club here is part of the men's league here at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center. We've been skating as a team here for about 10 years now, and it's a great opportunity for adults from around the community to get together, skate, enjoy each other's company, play hockey, engage in healthy exercise and healthy lifestyle, enjoy socialize. The past few years, we've noticed that the rink has really become run down. There's been a lot of problems with the management of the rink. They range from the locker rooms no longer being locked, leaving our valuables accessible to the general public, whoever happens to wander into the rink. For years, there was no women's changing facility. The females on our team had to change in a bathroom and then put their equipment in our room for safekeeping once the men had all exited. The shape of the rink has gone down. There's ruts in the ice and holes in the ice, which present a danger to the skaters. Even just the scheduling of the teams, we don't find out, you know, the entire length of the schedule. You get it in 2 week blocks. Sometimes you get three games in 1 week. Other times you won't get any games for another 3 weeks or even up to a month. Water bottles aren't being provided, and they're probably the most egregious of all. Especially to the working class guys on our team.
It's the fact that they've increased prices significantly
over the past few months, and yet we've seen a decrease in services, the number of games that we played, as well as the aforementioned facilities that we're playing. So when our team, we commiserate in the locker room, talk about these conditions, And when we heard Legislator Tyner's radio show the other week, we felt like we weren't alone. We felt like we finally had a voice. We felt like we finally had somebody who could advocate for us and for the community and try to do what's best for this facility and for the people of Dutchess County. So we're very hopeful that something can be done to restore this to the proper way that it should be run and make it a valuable asset that it should be for the people of Dutchess County.
The only thing I'd like to add, I've been a member.
What's your name?
My name is Bill Hemke. I'm also an assistant captain with the Black Rhinos Hockey Club, and I've been a member of that hockey club since 2005. I also was president of Millbrook Youth Hockey for almost 3 years, and I represented kids ranging in age from 4 all the way up to 16 years of age, and we made it. We made a strong push to have big representation here at the Civic Center because of the locality of it. Millbrook Youth Hockey was very happy with the services that were provided at one time. I stepped down a couple of years ago, but I've definitely seen the things that Greg has spoken of, the deterioration of what's going on here. And it's unfortunate because our youth hockey players are playing here, and the ice conditions are so bad that they're in a dangerous situation now. You can't even see the lines on the ice anymore, and the employees that I dealt with and the acquaintances I've had here, they've had some very good employees over the years. They are few and far between. I don't know them anymore, and most of them have left, including Lori May, who was just an incredible asset to this facility. I dealt with contracts with her when I was president, and I was really heartbroken to hear that she had left. I don't even know the circumstances of why she left, but she was a great and valuable asset to this facility. So, you know, that's why I'm here. We have a voice now. Thank you to the legislature and the letter from Joanne and Legislature Tyner for representing us.
I have my prepared statement.
Thank you.
I didn't decide to speak until today, so I had to write everything down. My name is Joanne Kuczynski. My daughter's a figure skater at the Ice Time Sports Complex in New York.
Where do you live?
Washingtonville? Yes. The recent changes that I've seen at Ice Time are concerning and have outraged many parents. And I just bulleted some notes that I think are imperative for everyone to know. With no advance notice to parents, a 4% surcharge was imposed if you paid with a credit card at Ice Time. When I questioned this, the hostile response to me was they needed to cover any and all bank charges imposed on them. And then I got a door slammed in my face. After pushback from many parents, the sign at the front desk disappeared. The Learn to Skate program at Ice Time was thriving when it was affordable and when it offered a two pair of skates at registration. It is my opinion that the increased cost and no longer offering the free skates devastated the program. The exorbitant increases across the board for the location have deemed to be very poor business decisions. The holiday show in December, again at Ice Time, had the worst turnout in 20 years. For the first time, skaters were charged $20 to participate in a solo and or group program, and we all found that outrageous. I feel the coaches at Ice Time have been mistreated and taken advantage of. Some have skated that facility since childhood. It is my opinion that they have chosen not to speak out because of the fear of retribution from management. I don't blame them, not one bit.